I'm sorry for the delay tonight. I was supposed to start at 6 and my blood sugar decided to go low, such as being a diabetic. So today I wanted to show you something I've done a few times in the past, and I forgot to bring out my old, I brought out a more newer one that I've done. But you can use stamping up and stamping up products to make really pretty art projects. I've seen some beautiful ones that some of the girls on our demonstrator website, hi Jane, on our demonstrator website, that you can only join those girls if you are a demonstrator, and they have beautiful art to show, and they're just gorgeous. And so one of the girls said, I told her I was thinking of doing an art piece, like something that I could hang up. And she said, oh, I would love to see it. So now I'm like, okay, Melissa, you're gonna have to get things going and start making your art. So I did order out of the new catalog, and I got five brand new sets. That so I decided to use all of my sets to make art for this new catalog. So I'm just gonna show you if I can find my other art piece. I'll show you that one too, but this one was the one I made in spring. So I just did flowers, and you always have to, with these ones, you always have to have a color scheme. So go with a color scheme. Sorry, I should have taken the glass off. You can't see that very well. Oh, I'm glad to hear it, Sheila. I'm glad your order came. So that is that. Let me see if I can pull my other ones quickly out to show you. Like I said, guys, sorry for the delay. I was supposed to start at 6, and that didn't happen. And I don't think very clearly once when my blood sugar is really low, so sometimes I just have to deal with that until I feel better, and then I can pop online. So this is one of my other art projects. I'm not sure why it's not coming in very clear. Sorry, let me adjust this, see if I can get it a little bit clearer for you. There we go. So my dancing lady. And then I made this one. So those are a few of my art pieces. So I'm gonna bring you down here. I'm gonna show you. I'm not gonna do the whole art piece tonight. It does take time. But the little squares that you do it, they don't take much time. So you can do pretty much maybe probably 5 squares in an hour. So it doesn't take a long time to do these art projects, or these like, yeah, little art framed art. But I'm gonna bring you down here, and I have it up higher tonight so you can see what I'm doing. So there is my frame so far. So I've taken, and I didn't bring over my book, and I should have. So I'm gonna read you off what. So this paper here is called the Love You Always Foil Sheets. So it's a pink color, and I just used numbers because I wanted to do 2021 as kind of a symbolic year to that things got better, that we've learned to deal with different things, like learn to deal with things online, and things got better. So I wanted to do a 2021 and then show the new stamp sets that have come out in 2021. So those are a few of my squares, and I'm going to show you them up close. So these are the ones that I've done so far. And then I'm going to tell you my color combo. And I'm going to show you a few of them tonight. And I'm going to give you all of the directions because These things are not hard to do at all, but I'll give you the directions of how to put one together in the information after. So those are some of my new stamp sets that I use. I didn't use Celebration just because Celebration's only 2 months, so I wanted to do something that would be a few months. So the colors I used for my color scheme here is I use Bermuda Bay, I use Highland Heather, I use Flirty Flamingo, and I use Pool Party. So those are the colors I've used. And so the pink here kind of goes with the color scheme. You could also have used purple for the middle, or used white. You could have done different things. I just wanted to use this new foil. It's very, very pretty. So I'm just going to move that off to the side. It's not put together, so I'm going to move it off to the side, and then I'm going to show you a few other stamps that I just got today. So I walked in the door and I had a whole bunch of stamp sets. So I'm going to try to put this down without losing half of it. There we go. And I still have my snowflakes up. I know I should have something different now, but I don't have different colors for each day. Thanks, Jane. These like art pieces are so much fun to do. I have so much fun doing them, and then you display them. So when people walk into your house, they're like, "Oh, look at that." And they're like, "Oh, who made that?" And you say, "I did." And they say, "Oh my gosh, that's gorgeous." And sometimes they'll ask you to make them one. And they're really easy to do. So before I start this, I was going to go through a few points. So because with this frame is a frame from the dollar store. So I don't buy really expensive frames. You could buy expensive frames, but these are ones from the dollar store. And I find just the way they sit, and the way they stay, these things stay in, and you can put them on a counter or, yeah, just like on a counter. I really like these frames. But I mean, you can get a frame from anywhere. It's you can use frames from anywhere for it. What else did I want to say? So for the little squares, so the background, the green background that I was using there, that is background is 8 by 10 inches. Each little square, like these little squares here, they're 2 1/4 by 2 1/4. So I'll write those down for you. But they're tiny squares. So when you're doing your picking what image you want to stamp, and I'm going to show you what stamp set that comes from, you're wanting to get an image that'll fit in that square or something like make it fancy. Now, I use the 2021 in the middle of mine. The other one I use summer. You don't have to use words in it. You could just fill up the whole image with. So that would be 12 of the squares would fill up your whole image. You could put like love in the middle. I have like a little love die cut out here that I could have put in the middle, but I just wanted to do 2021. So you can do whatever you would like in the middle of it, or you could fill up the whole thing with squares. Sometimes you can do a theme like animals if you want to do like animal theme, if you want to do flower theme. If you want to do ocean theme, there is a new ocean set that I just got, and I was thinking of maybe doing another frame with just the ocean pieces, which would look really pretty. Yeah, and that's all I wanted to do. I just wanted to make sure I went over a few things. So I'm going to show you my stamp sets as I go. So the first one I'm using here is the frame is the outside frame is 7.5 inches by 9.5 inches. No, the entire frame is 11 5/8 by 9 5/8 inches, and the inside that I the inside of the frame where you see in the window is a 7.5 inches by 9.5 inches. So the frame itself is 11 5/8 by 9 5/8. So the first stamp we're going to look at today is the Forever and Always. So that's the one I'm going to stamp with. And then these are the framelits. So this one has love. I don't know if you can see that very well. And always. So you could have put love or always in the middle of your frame. It would have been really pretty. But I'm going to use 2021 for that one. So that's the first one we're going to do tonight. Like I said, I don't know how far I'll get because sometimes these are really quick to do and sometimes they're not. So, and these are brand new, so sometimes they take a little bit more ink and I don't know how they stamp because I've never used them before. So some stamps are better to stamp than others. Ooh, and that's a very, very pretty stamp. So that's just one of the flowers. So when I'm coloring this in, and I don't know if it has any leaves in the stamp set, so let me check that, because I might want to put some leaves in. Yeah, they do have leaves. So I'm going to put those in, because the thing is, you want to add some of that green that's in your background to your sample here. So they have little leaves for this in the stamp. So I'm just going to add, I don't know if I'm going to add them to the bottom or add them to the top. I'm going to add one there. And it kind of looks like it's not connected to anything. Like I said, these might not turn out so great. This is a brand new stamp set, so I don't know how it'll work together. So I'm going to do just some leaves at the bottom. You could probably do leaves all around if you wanted to, but I just kind of give it a base at the bottom. And then what you're going to do is you're going to take your color. So you're going to take whatever green color you decide to use. So I'm going to do the light Bermuda Bay, and I'm going to color that in, and then I'm going to shade it with the dark Bermuda Bay. So I'm using my Stampin' Blends for this. And I just stamped down in Memento. So the Memento is great to use with the Stampin' Blends. Other black ink sometimes doesn't work with the Stampin' Blends just because they're alcohol markers. So you're just going to color that in. And then I have pink. Oh, we're not going to do that yet. I'm going to jump into doing the highlight. There we go. So I just highlight them a little bit. So just like that. I'm going to show you that up close. So just highlight them. And then in this inside, we're going to do pink and we're going to do the purple. So I'm going to do two different colors. So I'm going to do the entire thing in the light pink first. And for the amount of use I've gotten out of this pink one, so I probably have had these for 3 or 4 years now. This one's starting to get a little bit dry, and sometimes they do that. There's nothing really much you can do besides buy a new one. They don't last forever because of how much I use them. I usually use them maybe once a day or 3 times a week. So, I mean, because of the amount of times I use them, you sometimes will have to buy new ones when they start running out. So that's why it's making that sound right now. Okay, so I'm going to take my highlighter and I'm going to highlight those with the, so you're just going to take the dark flirty flamingo and you're just going to highlight any type place that has a highlight. So all these little tiny lines, you're just going to highlight where it tells you to. So I'm not making those up, they're right there, and I'm going to highlight those. That's the nice thing about Stampin' Up, is most of their stamps have lines to show you where to highlight, so you don't have to think about that all by yourself. You don't have to be an artist to color things in. So there's that. And I'm going to do purple in the middle. So I'm actually like doing different colors, not blending them in. I might go over with the pink again in the middle to make it blend a little bit. We will see. The fun part about this is you kind of don't know what you do, like you're going to do until you start doing it. Now, I do have a dye for this one, so I could have popped it out a bit. And see, that's really light purple, so it does look really nice in the middle of that. And what I might do is take the light purple and go over the pink down here just to make it blend a little bit. So that is our flower. Now, another thing we could do with that flower to just add a little bit to it is take our Wink of Stella, sparkle it up a little bit, and just go over it with a Wink of Stella. I think everybody needs Wink of Stella. It's like a mandatory thing in your art box. So then it gets a little bit more shimmery. I don't know if you can see the shimmery on it. It's pretty dark in here tonight. So that's my one. So I'm going to just put that to the side. And that's going to go on my board. And then I'm going to start to do another one. So my next one I'm going to do, I don't know which one to do next. So I've pre-cut, so I have these like little flowers here, and then I got this little guy. So I'll show you the stamp set and the, so this is Kangaroo and Company. And Kangaroo and Company, hi Marlene, hi Joan, Kangaroo and Company is this one here. So I wanted to put the big kangaroo on my square, but it doesn't fit. So there's this little kangaroo here down at the bottom. So I'm going to use him. And then there's these flowers. So down here in the, sorry, this corner here. That's why I'm going backwards. My hands are backwards to what the video shows. Anyways, so that right there, that is the flowers. And I'm going to use that as a background and then put the little guy on the front. So, and I'm going to use the colors that I'm using. I'm going to probably use a little bit of brown for him and then use the pink to highlight him. And then these are the framelits, so that's set. So I've already used the framelit to cut out the little kangaroo. The big kangaroo didn't fit in my square, so I decided not to use it. You can use bigger images though on your square. And I just cut it out beforehand so you guys wouldn't have to wait for me to cut everything out. Just because my Stampin' Emboss machine, it does not fit on my table very well. Alright, so what we're going to do is I'm not even sure where I'm going to put it. I'm going to take my flowers, I'm going to stamp it down there. And I'm going to stamp it down here. Oops. And I'm just going to kind of make him I was gonna try to make him so it looks like he is standing in front of a bunch of flowers. So I just stamped them down like that. And if I wanted to go over this one, I could again, just because I leaned on my board here and it kind of flipped a little bit. So, but I don't need to go over it again. I'm going to color it in, so that's okay. And then I'm going to put him right here, so it looks like he's bouncing around a bunch of flowers. And you can put him up higher and make the flowers different. It doesn't matter where you put the, like, him or the flowers. It's up to you. So whatever you decide. Like I said, you just play with it. See what you want to do. I might add a few more little flowers down here. Just to fill in that space a little bit. It's not filling in very well. Where am I? There we go. That's better. So then I have filled in the space a little bit better, and my camera is moving on me. Sorry about that, guys. It's got a mind of its own, this camera. There we go. So I've covered that, and then what you're going to do is you're going to take him, and he's going to stand in the middle of the flowers. So what we're going to do is color those in. So again, we're keeping the same colors. I just forgot my brown, so let me grab some brown color here. Now, brown, grays, and blacks are your neutral colors. So if you're going to add a color to your color combination, so mine is, again, the Light Bermuda Bay, Bermuda Bay, Flirty Flamingo, and Highland Heather in Pool Party. So those are my colors. Now if you want to add a brown, so I'm adding Crumb Cake, or grays, or if you're going to add black, they're neutral colors, so you can add them in to your what you're making, as long as you add the other colors in. So I'm going to do that with the background. They should all blend together really nice, and it should look like the same piece. Oh, Marlene, I'll show you in a minute. I'll show you once I'm done this one. I'll show you one of what I'm doing with my little squares here. This is one of the things we used to do for team building or team meetings. So for team meetings, we used to get all together and we used to do these squares. So everybody would do one square, or we do, yeah, one square each. And if we have a 12 team, you can actually fill up your whole frame. So I will show you in a minute. I'm just going to finish him, and I'll show you the whole frame with those two extra ones that we did today. He's really tiny, so when you're coloring him in, feels like I've got my whole hand over top of him as I'm coloring him, because he's a little tiny guy. And then I'm going to take the pink. So the pink is one of my colors, the Flirty Flamingo, and I'm going to use the light one. And I'm going to color in his tummy. So that will blend him into the pink and purple flowers in the background. And then I colored also in his little ear. And then you probably want to color in his little nose, even though I think their noses are black. I'm going to make his nose pink. So that's what it looks like. And then we're going to take, for these little flowers, we're going to add, so I'm going to add to the leaves, you're just going to add your dark, so you could either add your Pool Party or your, why do I want to call this a different color every time? Bermuda Bay. I'm not sure why I want to call it a different color, but it is Bermuda Bay. We've had a lot of pretty, really pretty green colors in the past, so I think I'm trying to color one of the old colors. So there's leaves in here, and there's also these little squiggle things. So they're right here. So like more like these squiggle things like here. So I might make them different colors. I'm not too sure. Like I said, you don't have to have any plan with this. It's just creating. And if you don't like a square, it's only a tiny little square of paper. You can throw it out and do another one. So there's no harm or foul when doing these. And if you like something, I've flipped my squares over before because I didn't like the idea I had. Or the idea did not work. Sometimes your idea is just, you have this big idea in your head of what you want to do and it just doesn't work. And that's okay. So don't get upset when things don't work. Just start with a new paper and keep going. Sometimes things don't work out so well. And I've missed some leaves. There we go. It's funny how when you're coloring in, how you sometimes will find that you've missed something. There we go. So I got all my green in. And then the rest of the flowers, I'm going to do pink and purple. And then I'm going to show you my whole sheet again. And then I have more to do tonight. I'm just going to show you my plans for them because I'm not going to keep you guys online until 2 hours from now. I'm just going to keep you on for a little bit just to explain what I'm doing. But these are so much fun to do. I just love doing them. They're so much fun. And like I said, we used to do them for our team meetings. So people, each team member would bring, say there was 12 people in our team. Each team member would bring 12 of the same image and then hand them out. And then we would put those together. And I don't know where I had one like that here somewhere. I do not know where it went to. It might be in the box in the basement. I'm not sure. I was trying to keep my art all together like I did in the drawer here. But sometimes if you do so many things. Here's hoping you can see what I'm doing because these little squares are tiny, whiny, whiny. So I did the light purple. And then I'm just going to, and those are the squiggly things. I don't know if they're supposed to be roses or what they're supposed to be or just little squiggly things. I'm not too sure. But they're really cute. So I decided to make those ones purple. And the flowers I'm going to make pink. And then I'm just highlighting with my, in those little circles, with my darker color. Oh, it looks like I missed that one totally. And sorry, it is hard to see with my gigantic hands in the way when it's such a little tiny square of paper. Alright, so there you go with the purple part. Okay, and then the last part I'm going to do the pink. So the pink I'm going to do the light pink. So I'm going to use the small side. Don't use the big side with these little guys because you'll end up making a mess. Unless you're trying to get the whole thing colored in like I did the flower earlier. And it looks like I missed some more leaves there. So I'm going to come back and do those in a minute. Unless that's a gigantic, maybe we could just make it a gigantic flower. Let's do that. There we go. So I think I've missed all the same leaves on each one, so. Like I said earlier, there's no rules to this, so whatever you want to do, it's up to you. Your color scheme, that's up to you too. I usually go with a purple, green, purple or a pink, a green or a blue, and then kind of go from there. Pink or red or purple, and then a green or a blue color to go with your kind of your color scheme. My mom always says that I'm really good with my color combining, but I think that just comes with time and knowing what colors kind of go really nice together. This one is very, very much pastel, a pastel color theme. I missed another little purple thingy here. There we go. Some more green. There we go. Okay, so there are our flowers. Okay, and then what we're going to do is we're going to take some dimensionals, which I did have here a minute ago, and of course I probably cleaned them up because I didn't think I need them, but you do need dimensionals for these because sometimes things look better with dimensionals. Of course, I clean up thinking I don't need something, and I do need it. Alrighty. So what we're going to do is we're going to take his head, put a dimensional on his head, and then put a dimensional on his bottom part. So you only need two for that. You don't need 12 of them on there. He's only a little guy, so. And then I'm going to put him right in the middle of those flowers. So just like that. Okay, and then I'm going to show you Marlene. They would be great gifts. You're right. Especially since if you're doing a bunch of them, once you repeat, or once you do one square, I could repeat that 10 more times, right? So we could make a whole bunch of gifts for people. And they're really easy to do, and they're a lot of fun. So I'm just going to show you the two that I've done. I'm not going to get into the other ones tonight just because I don't want to keep you guys on all night long. So those are all my pieces so far. And sorry, my paper is kind of moving there. So that's all of them. And I can move them around to make them look a little bit better. So if I want him down here. Like that. You can move them around to kind of like what suits your fancy. And there they all are. So I'm not going to go over the whole thing tonight. I just don't want to keep you guys online too long. But the other stamp sets I'm going to use. So I am going to use. I'm just going to show you. So I'm going to use this little guy, and then we're going to use this little guy. So he's a little snail, because I got that set, and I'll show you that set quick. So that's this set, snailed it. And the snailed it one comes with a little envelope. So I just cut the little guy out, but it comes with a little envelope, and it also comes with these little cute little mushrooms. It's adorable, and it comes out also with a little postage frame and a little postage tag here, so it's super cute. And that's again the stamp. And then the other one I'm going to do is the Hydrangea Haven, so that's that one there. And so this one's gigantic. So what I've decided to do with this one is I'm going to stamp it down something like this. So you can see the stamp there. And I'm going to color in the leaves with the green and then purple and pink in here. And then I'm not sure if I'm going to use that. That's kind of like if you wanted to stamp down on it. I don't know if I want to do that or if I want to just color it in. Again, it's gigantic, so it's not going to fit in there, but you can use half of it to fit in there, right? And So I showed that one, and then the last one is the seashell. So the seashells are, some of them, some of the images are a bit gigantic. So these three shells, or these two shells, are gigantic in the picture, or in the stamp set. They're big. So I can't use them in my square because I'll lose half of them. So I decided instead to use the little ones here. They're tinier. And so I'm going to, so I've cut the little silver dollar out, and then I'm going to do a background with these little guys. So all of those, I don't know if how well you can see those. So I'm going to do it with all of those, and then put that on top with a dimensional. So, I do too, Jane, but with this project, it's just not going to work with it. It's just, they're too big. Those, the stamp for that one is too big for this one. You'll lose half, you won't know what the image is. If you can get like most of your image on when it's a bigger stamp on these little squares, it's better. So anyways, that's my project, and I hope you got some inspiration from that and gave you some ideas. No, Marlene, the squares are, hold on, I'll get my paper out or I'll give you the wrong size. The frame itself, so the frame is 11 5/8 by 9 5/8. The paper, the green paper that I cut out, it's not called green paper. I'm going to keep calling it. It's Bermuda Bay. And that one I cut, the background is 8 by 10 inches. And then the squares, the little white squares, are 2 1/4 by 2 1/4 inches. Marlene, so that's how they work. But I'm gonna give you all of my little notes in the after I'm done into the I'm not sure what it's called, underneath the video, and so you can have those, and also put them in other spots just so you can have the information of those. Like I said, you probably wouldn't have been able to follow me tonight while doing this kind of art, but later on you can do it. So you just want to make sure your frame, so your green paper, your Bermuda Bay paper that I used today, you want to make sure that fits your frame. So you're going to measure your background to your frame, but the 2 1/4 inch little white squares are usually fit into those smaller frames. So that should be a good size to go with. That's usually what I use for my frames. But like I said, in the beginning, you weren't here, Marlene, but the frames I use are usually from the dollar store. So I don't buy really expensive frames to do my art, just because you don't really need to do really, really expensive. But if you do have an expensive frame, you can use that. But I just use the ones from the dollar store because I think they work really well for me. And if I do... I know, I keep saying green paper. I don't know why Bermuda Bay will not stay in my head tonight. It's too funny. But yeah, you just need a dollar store frame. You don't have to have anything too expensive. And it's really easy because these are little scraps. So the white paper I'm using tonight are little scraps of paper I've been saving over the years because they're tiny pieces. And so I'm not going to, like, I use them for cutting out things or, that kind of thing. Like when I'm wanting to, say, cut out a little, image, I use those little pieces of paper, but you end up, like, storing so much of those little pieces of paper that you don't know what to do with them. But this is a great way of doing something fun and doing a pretty project and getting rid of all of your white, small pieces of paper. So it's a great way of doing that. Anyways, thank you guys so much for joining me, and there was a lot of people on tonight, so that was great, and I will see you next Tuesday, and I'm going to show you this done as soon as I get it done. I don't know if I'm going to get it done tonight or some other day this week. a BB paper would be better, right? So I've tried to show you the project finished. So I'll post that this week. And I'm also probably going to do a few of the new stamp sets that I have. I'm going to probably do a few of them and some of the other stamp sets that I showed last weekend for my catalog release party. I will be going over them and showing you different projects, different ways of using them, different techniques. And like I said earlier, I'm just going to move those on the floor before I end up with a crash of stamp sets hitting the floor. Just wanted to say thanks everybody who came to my catalog release party last week. I did it from Monday through Sunday. I know that was a lot of days to get people to come and watch me. And I did do very well in sales for those. And I'm so excited that I was able to buy a whole bunch of stamp sets that I originally thought I wasn't going to be able to buy any of them. And I was able to buy tons of them because of the little promotions we get from Stampin' Up from selling things. I did was able to order some, like order a bunch of stamp sets, so it was helped me out great. So I was so excited about that. And thank you everybody who just came and watched me, and the people who I had to send videos to, who don't have Facebook. Those people, I thank them greatly too, because they do, everybody keeps me motivated. And it's really hard with COVID to stay motivated and try to keep doing cards and sending cards to people. And so I've been trying my best to keep motivated and keep going and do the best I can with, like, just trying to think of new things to show you guys. And sometimes that gets tricky. But hopefully this year we will have every Tuesday I'll show you something new. Hopefully it's something you've never seen before, or a different technique, or a card that you really like that you might want to share with somebody else. And I will see you on Tuesday. And I hope you like this project. Like I said, I will give you all the measurements after. If you want to repeat the project, just because I know it's hard. The numbers don't stay in my head. So I've said those numbers probably 6 times during the whole meeting here, or the whole video here, and I still don't remember what they are. So I will write those all down for you, so then you can make some of those projects at home. Like I said, there's no rules to it, so if you don't want to put the year in the middle, you can put, yeah, Jane, I can show Funfold cards. The only thing is my video sometimes doesn't let me, I would have to get professional lighting, and I can't afford professional lighting to show you how to fold them. It's very hard to see. So that's the only thing with Funfold and those kind of techniques, because they really do need somebody to show you step by step. And sometimes it's really hard, but I will try to do some in the upcoming videos, okay? What else were I gonna say? Yeah, so that's all for tonight. Thank you so much for your ideas, and thank you so much for coming out to my catalog release party, and I hope to see everybody next week. Have a good week, everybody.